قاسم محمد
الله
وعلى أهل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين المحسومين الذين أذاب الله عنهم الرجس وطهرهم تطهيرا
اللهم صل على محمد
My dear brothers and sisters and distinguished, I would like to ask this question. Why are we here at this time of the day? When it's raining, it's a time to be home and we are here.
Yes.
Why are we chanting Al-Baqee? Why Baqee is so important to us? When we know that Al-Baqee is an Arabic word, and this is for those who might not know what is this all about. Al-Baqee is a name chosen by our dear Prophet, given to a piece of land, which Allah told him to make that piece of land to be a burial place for chosen and fallen heroes of Islam.
MashaAllah.
And that Al-Baqee that we here for, that piece of land contains so many important individuals. One of them are companions of the Prophet, which some of their scholars is called Imam Malik. He said there are more than 10,000 companions buried in there. Of those companions, let me share with you, one of them is known as Uthman ibn Mad'un. Uthman ibn Mad'un is a great companion, which Imam Ali loves so much. And he said, I named my son Uthman because of this great man. Because he was a great companion, very mu'min, very dedicated. That Uthman ibn Mad'un is buried there. That is one of the important heroes. Number two, there are other important individuals also who were buried there as the wives of our dear Prophet. One of those wives is known as Umm Salama, who the Prophet made her to be one of the, those who tell the history of Karbala. When the sand was brought to Jabal from Jabra'il to the Prophet gave to this Umm Salama and told her, Ya Umm Salama, keep this sand which was brought to me by Jabra'il from the land of Karbala. The day that the sand turns to blood, that is an indication that Hussein is killed in Karbala. This great woman is buried in Baqee. Not only that, also the mother of Abu al-Fadl Abbas, Umm al-Baneen, she is buried there. These important individuals are all there. Not only that, also the son of the Prophet, called Ibrahim, also buried there, which the Prophet cried when he died. And he says, تَدْمَعُ الْعَيْنِ وَيَحْزَنُ الْقَلْبِ وَلَا نَقُولُ مَا يُسْخَتُ الرَّبِّ. I said, we're crying. The heart is filled of grief, but we are not going to say things that is going to displease Allah. His son, Ibrahim, is buried in Baqee. Yes. More importantly, the grandson of the Prophet, known as Imam al-Hasan alayhi salam. Also, he's buried there, the first grandson. Not only that, Imam Zain al-Abidin, the other grandson. The third grandson, Imam Muhammad al-Baqir, is buried there. The fourth, Imam Ja'far al-Sadiq, also is buried there. All of these heroes are buried in this land called Al-Baqee. And people used to go there and pray and ask Allah for forgiveness and charge their energy with those individuals. But the Saudis came and destroyed that shrine. That today, you are not allowed to read dua. You are not allowed to take any book in there. Women are not allowed to go there. Where is the justice? This is why we are here, to ask for justice and asking for rebuilding that Baqee, where everybody can go there and perform their prayers, and more importantly, to pay their respect to those heroes.
Al-Baqee! Al-Baqee!
We build Al-Baqee!
Al-Baqee! Al-Baqee!
We build Al-Baqee!
Al-Baqee! Al-Baqee!
We build
Al-Baqee, Al-Baqee.
We built Al-Baqee.
Al-Baqee, Al-Baqee.
We built Al-Baqee.
My dear brothers and sisters, the last is to remind our fellow American citizens that this place is so important to us today. As you know, in America, we have Memorial Day, where everything goes on stop just to mark and remember those heroes of America. Now, these people that we are here asking for rebuilding their shrines, they are our Muslim fallen heroes, those who gave everything they have for Islam and sacrificed everything they have for this religion. So they deserve some respect, and they deserve honorism. And we are going to remember them and make sure that Baqee is built. Wow. Until then, we will always say, Al-Baqee, Al-Baqee.
Al-Baqee, Al-Baqee. Al-Baqee, Al-Baqee.